Blackstone presents Delia Akeley and the Monkey, a human-animal story of captivity, patriarchy, and nature by Iain McCalman. This book is read by Daniel Moore. For Gail McCalman and Bruce Wilson, in gratitude for your infinite generosity, support, wisdom, and love. Prologue, To Catch a Monkey. Mickey, as Delia Akeley liked to be called, wanted to prove to an opinionated man that he was wrong about monkeys. It was late October 1909, and she was camped with her husband Carl Akeley and two hunter colleagues on the Tana River in British East Africa, many miles east of Nairobi. Carl Akeley, a famed collector and taxidermist of African animals, working for the American Museum of Natural History in New York, had embarked on an expedition to shoot and collect a family group of five or six elephants for future display. Ake, as his friends called him, was celebrated for lifelike taxidermy and implacable toughness. He carried scars from an earlier expedition when he'd killed a wounded female leopard with his bare hands. This kind of reputation had generated a request from two wealthy American would-be hunters to accompany the expedition for a short time to collect big game trophies. In exchange for Ake's guidance, they'd supplied much-needed financial help. Since arriving in British East Africa, Ake had encountered unexpected difficulties in locating the old, giant, heavily tusked bull elephants he wanted to head this family group. He had high hopes of the new camp in the Tana River region because the area had been long closed to European hunters as a result of severe outbreaks of fever and sleeping sickness among the African population. Thanks to the hunters' absence, the riverbanks and hinterland of the Tana region were now said to be thronging with game. On this particular evening, Ake, a fanatical workaholic, was busy in his tent, preserving skins and developing photographs, while Mickey and the two Americans, journalist John T. McCutcheon Jr. and businessman Fred Stevenson, were enjoying the most relaxed part of the safari day. McCutcheon, a lanky, sardonic cartoonist for the Chicago Tribune, well-known socialite and friend of ex-President Theodore Roosevelt, had heard Ake give a talk about African hunting and impulsively asked to join the next safari in the hope of experiencing, quote, the call of the wild to which the pre-Adamite monkey in our nature responds, end quote. Fred Stevenson, a hulking, quietly spoken Chicago businessman, could already boast considerable hunting experience in North America. Mickey, Ake's supporting hunter, had also been tasked by the American Museum with gathering a collection of African artifacts and shells, made up the third of the fireside party. McCutcheon would describe this daily post-hunting ritual amusingly in his subsequent account of the expedition in Africa. Each evening, after taking a bath in a metal tub and slipping into long, soft, mosquito-proof boots, they'd eat at 6 o'clock sharp, just as darkness exploded over the tropical evening. Sitting comfortably in camp chairs, they'd spend a drowsy hour or two having a shari, discussion debate, about the day's events. As they chatted, the sounds of the African night swelled and multiplied into a cacophony around them. Hyenas howled, zebras barked, lions coughed, and cicadas shrieked. Oblivious to the noise, an African askari, soldier, rifle over shoulder, paced up and down in front of their tents with a nightly mission to deter lions and other such hazards. Beyond the line of their tents, the Americans could hear the porters, huddled in small groups around a separate campfire. One was playing a melodious tin whistle, another a French harp. A few were singing in harmony. Others laughed and gossiped about the follies of the Mzungu, white people. Tonight, the Mzungu were having a shari about monkeys and zoos, a subject on which Mickey held strong feelings. She loved monkeys and hated zoos. On a previous African safari with Ake in 1905, she'd spent most of her spare time observing the social lives of colobus monkeys and baboons as they capered within the forests of Mount Kenya. While Ake was out shooting elephants, Mickey would head off with an African guide into the depths of the forest until they found a monkey feeding ground. Here, ignoring insect bites, she'd lie under one of the huge wild fruit trees for hours, watching the sinuous black and white monkey.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.